Oh my god.
Hey guys, welcome back. So today I'm going to be reacting to myself watching myself. Truthfully, I've seen this show one time. I gotta be honest, I was nervous. Like super nervous, had like a blanket over my head half the time. So I wanted to take a second, rewatch the show, have some reaction to it. So let's give this a go. I think it'd be pretty funny to see some of these scenes and relive Million Dollar Beach House. You can see I have my drink here, prepared for this. Here we go. Let's get it going. Episode 1, scene 1, intro, start, boom.
Today I want you to bring Mike, Peggy, and Noel through, and I want to see how you would show the house if I wasn't there.
Okay. It's beautiful.
Welcome, guys. 21 Kellis Way.
Today is JB's show. This is his first big listing.
Congrats.
Thank you. We just want to make sure he's ready for when the buyers actually come.
Okay, we're not even like, we're like a minute in. First big listing. This was over 2 years ago, so this is a big one for me. Since then, a lot's happened. A lot of sales, a lot of listings, a lot of everything. So I want to see how I react in my first real tour on my first Million Dollar property.
Kellis Way is a super cool property. It's an 8-bedroom, 8.5-bath, $7 million Hampton's house.
You got the stats right, that's good. From the ocean.
When you walk in, there's a fortress-like feel inside the home. Really awesome custom finishes and things that you just don't see everywhere else. It has an indoor-outdoor flow. Brazilian Ipe wood deck.
Brazilian Ipe wood. That's bringing out some big, that's some big time specs for a first showing. Good shit, let's go.
Overlooking the backyard. It's a really serene setting. You know, 7,000 plus square feet.
Make sure you're saying 2 acres. That's
yeah.
Jimmy's already got to interrupt. I mean, come on. I said like 4 words and he's already butting in. That's what Jimmy does. Love Jimmy. He's just a killer. But goddamn, let me do my thing.
My name is JB. I'm 28 years old.
28? Now I'm 30.
In other markets, I worked in Manhattan for about a year, but I just didn't see the trajectory. I didn't feel like it was the place for me.
So many pauses already. Sorry. First time seeing myself in a live interview situation. Looking okay. Looking good. Moving on.
So I decided to move back home to the Hamptons. And now I'm back to ground zero. I'm a rookie again. I want to take you through.
Can I have a first question?
Already off the bat, I like your style.
Typical Peggy. I mean, I barely said the stats and she's already butting in with a question. Love her. Very on brand for Pegs.
Ceilings are actually 25 feet high. Big open space. It's the first thing I noticed when I walk in.
Yeah.
It's like, well, let's show them the best part. How sweet is this?
We've got a really nice backyard.
You have the custom built in barbecue off to your right.
Damn right you do.
Infinity pool overlooking Kellis Pond. It's beautiful. There's actually a private entryway down here. You can do some fishing. You have a really nice, large master suite.
Electric shades?
Electric shades.
It's a smart house.
It's absolutely a smart house.
Are the heated floors?
In every bathroom.
Is this the air bubble jet? Because there's a spa jet that has like air bubbles.
Wow, you're really picking up the details today, Peggy. Kitchen?
Yes, sir.
Nice.
What do you notice first about here?
Pizza oven, baby.
A wood burning pizza oven.
You should have pizza during your open house.
That's a great idea.
Can you eat?
I've never had a pizza oven. That's pretty cool.
Real estate is definitely a fast track to your career. In the Hamptons, you can grow really quick. I mean, you could see me. I went from zero to being one of the top brokers in just 5 years. Last year, I did over $2.5 million in commission. But in order to survive in this business, you have to love real estate. You have to.
What Jimmy just said, spot on. Couldn't be any more spot on.
Breathe it, eat it, and sleep it.
Wow.
So pretty.
All right, we got enough of Kellis Way. Let's move on. We're gonna fast forward here. We need to see a little Michael. We need to see a little Fulf. First office scene, I think. This is the first office scene. Bridgehampton office. Michael, Peggy, Noel is there.
Good morning,
Henderson. I'm walking in.
All American.
are we doing?
Being good, a brother. Diva.
Mike, how's the doctor's appointment for your wife?
It went amazing. So we're having a boy. His name is going to be Luca.
Congrats, nice, man.
Thank you, thank you. My name is Michael. I am 30 years old. I've been with
all right. Sorry, he hasn't even spoke yet. I'm already laughing. Michael is exactly, and not, we're all like the same person on TV and what you're seeing here. Michael is to a T, like this is him, and he doesn't change for anyone, doesn't change for cameras, doesn't change for producers, doesn't change for clients. He's going to be himself throughout everything. And that's the coolest part about Michael.
Here, we did the 3D ultrasound, and he has the same exact nose as me, which could
so
be
it's definitely yours.
Yes.
Okay.
This good. Could be a blessing or a curse. So
you did pretty well for yourself. So
thank
I
you,
think
thank
he'll
you.
Be
no,
fine.
It's your face.
It does fit my face. I just hope it fits shape. His face, and it probably won't for the first 13 years. Me and my beautiful wife recently found out that we're having a baby. So needless to say, life is coming at me extremely fast. I need to thank as
my high school friends who have obviously all watched this, who know Michael and I from when we were growing up and doing crazy things in high school. They actually played a game. They drank for every time Michael said baby. And I think that's a common little thread throughout this entire first season is Michael talking about his baby, Michael acting like he's having the baby. Bruh, it's just Michael though. That's who he is. All right, we'll continue on.
Much money as possible this summer to provide for the family. There is an Andreassi fund for the college. So
I didn't agree to that.
Yeah, no, you did. So we greatly appreciate the contribution.
Michael and I have been best friends since high school. We played football together. At that time, he was 6'4", 285 pounds. As a 14-year-old, you're like, who made this guy? Like, who is this? And do I have to, like, tackle him? Like, I don't know. Like, do I want to play football? I saw the soccer team playing, too. I was like, maybe I should just, like, drop the pants and go, like,
okay. That is, like, that's, like, 100% spot on. This is the biggest dude on the field. I mean, a head's length above the next tallest, biggest guy on our football team. And that's where our relationship really blossomed.
Ivy League, you can even pay for it. You'll be fine.
We're both in slightly different places in our lives right now. He's now gonna be a father, which is like way beyond me right now. I'm just trying to get by.
All I have to do is figure out how to be a father. So I think that hopefully comes naturally. Or YouTube. Poor kid.
That's enough office. We're gonna fast forward and get to some more juicy stuff. I think it's gonna be when Michael does his, what is that, Patty Shack? When Michael does the Patty Shack tour, I think we need a get to that one. I do recall that scene and a lot of people having some shaky feedback on that. Let's go to that. Before we get there, let's go to the skateboarding scene. One scene that I thought probably with the amount of shooting, so that's one thing to know. We did so much shooting. I mean, goodness, 3 months, every day, hours and hours. So what you're seeing is about, I would say about 20 to 25% of the entirety of us filming, right? I thought one scene that could most that was most definitely going to be cut was the skateboarding scene. Who the hell wants to see two late 20-year-olds, actually Mike was 30 at the time, skateboarding down this little, looks like a nice little neighborhood development on a longboard? I mean, a little weird. People had some mixed emotions on this one. So let's just play this one out. Let's see how this goes.
Dude, it's cool that I'm back in town.
Yeah.
It's crazy that you're working for the same
cool,
company,
bro.
Which...
What's a chance, dude? Out of all the brokerages we end up together, I mean, it's fate. We belong together.
This is my bail spot. I already mapped it out.
Use your foot! Use your foot!
Okay, athlete.
I've known JB since I'm 15 years old, almost 15 years now. I feel like when we were little, this was way bigger.
I remember we're taking the go-karts back.
Yeah. We would just end up in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah, exactly.
JB came up to me out on a football field, and it was literally love at first sight. He's my best friend, and I love him to death like a brother.
I'll meet you there, though.
I do have to stop it on that. Michael, man, I have a whole lot of friends, a whole lot of people that I get along with in this world, and very, very supporting and loving family. My brother's my best friend, too. My sister is amazing. Michael is one of those guys. He is the most loyal person in the universe, and will do anything for his friends, especially the ones that really mean a lot to him. And it's really cool because I've had a lot of friends growing up, high school, college, post-college in New York City. And like, he's that one dude that, like, if anything were to happen, you call Michael and he'll be there no matter what. 3 o'clock in the morning, you're across the country, you're in a serious legal bind, which that's hypothetical, that wouldn't happen. But just saying, point is, he'd be there. You can say whatever you want. You can say he's a clown, he's too goofy, he's too dramatic, but like, he is such a solid dude. And that's the coolest thing about him. He'll always be there for me. We'll always be friends for the rest of our lives. Isn't that cool? To know that you're gonna have someone for the rest of your life.
I wouldn't beat you there, bro.
I've always been like an ultimate competitor. At Dartmouth, I had the scholarship to the football team. I thought, oh, coming out of New York, I'm the best.
Let's break a bone. You gotta be careful, dude.
Freshman year, I thought I should start. But there's guys 3 years ahead of me, and they're ballers too. That was my first taste of like, all right, this is the real world. There are people that are just as good of you as you, or not better. Selling real estate in the Hamptons is the same thing, but in the working world.
It's a battle of attrition out here. You know, high-end developers, real estate brokers, people we aspire to be. For us to come in and just think we're gonna make an impact, it's a little bit naive.
With JP's competitive nature, he has to always be the best. Now he's to that point where it's make or break, and he's getting a little bit nervous, but there's nothing he has to be nervous about, because he's gonna do great.
This is like the real deal.
Dude, we are the future of the real estate business. It's simple. We're coming in now and there's a change of guard. All these big agents are threatened. It's not because they, because they're fucking.
Gotta pause it here too. I think what I was trying to say here was, it is truly the most competitive nature environment for agents, advisors, developers, attorneys, mortgage brokers. Every little piece that goes into a real estate transaction, they know this is the most competitive, one of the most competitive environments to transact in the country. So here, Michael's saying that, you know, we're already there. We're already the best, or, you know, these agents that have been here for 30 plus years should be scared. They're not scared. They're certainly not scared of us. We're trying to make an impact and take a little piece, right? That's how you have to approach it. When you're this young, when a lot of our clients are, you know, multimillionaires, billionaires, and they're all in their 50s, 60s, 70s, it's very difficult to earn their trust when you're in your 20s and you really haven't done a whole lot out here yet, right? So my approach is a little different. It's creating a process, knowing that the process may take 3, 5, 10 years to get to the place of where some of these really, really good advisors are now. They had to start somewhere. They've obviously worked their way up to be established and have the connections in the network to do, you know, multi-million dollar deals, 10, 20, 30 of them per year. It takes time to get there. So that's where I had a little bit of a differing in opinion with Michael.
He's gonna do everything you possibly can to succeed.
The sunrise happens, right?
Sunrise is right here.
Sunrise to sunset. So every morning you can have a natural alarm go off. It's a $6 million alarm. I'll take it.
First of all, Michael looks absolutely fucking hammered right now. I don't know if that's just, might be the lighting. It could be, no, I think he's just drunk. I think he was just, had a couple too many cocktails with his clients.
You know, look super happy. So let's talk about this.
Yeah.
Obviously, you know, we went for a different vision.
I'm not digging it.
Just fucking ruined my day.
Oh boy.
I have a house full of people. They're watching me tour the owner in her own property, and she has complete and utter disdain on her face. Her negativity could really affect potential buyers.
Let's move to positivity. Follow me.
Damage control time.
Holy fuck, I hate it.
Jesus. Not good. Not good. Holy, was that a quote unquote, holy fuck, I hate it? Yeah, it's not what you want. It's probably the last thing that you want out of an owner's mouth ever. Episode one of the books. We're moving on to episode two. Tune in next time. You'll see my feedback for episode two. Can't wait to watch it again with you.
Let me push play.